afar. Then my eyes turned westward, knowing that's the place that I love best of all. California.
Ouch. I wonder what it is. Let's see what's over here. Kind of neat how the wagon wheel turns that gear, then it turns that gear, and then it turns in here. And when this one turns, it turns that gear, and that gear makes that spin. It's a shame to see all this stuff just thrown like this. Couple of nice old oil pumps. And we can turn you back up, right? Now there's an old plow. And some more pieces of. And another old wagon. And an old push mower way over there. Yeah, pretty neat. Look at those gigantic steel wheels on it, though. Shame they just throw this shit into the weeds like this and leave it there. A DX20. Wonder what a DX20 is. Plowshare. There's where the nice equipment is. And here I am wearing socks and sandals again. Huh? I said here I am wearing socks and sandals waiting in the weeds. If there's any out here, I will find them. Now here's a nice old plow. That is really nice. Let's see if we can find the name on it. I can't tell what that is. Can't tell what that name is. Let's try it from the other side here. Oh, is that is what it is? Okay, now I can see it from this angle. That is John Deere. Ouch. Isn't that gorgeous? Yeah, it's hiding in there. And parts of another old plow. What a shame. What an honest shame that they don't try to preserve this stuff. The yellow one is a little newer. Not sure what that is. And then you got over here. Look at that. Ain't that something? When you look at all the mechanisms. That is neat as hell. Another old plow. Oh. Look at that. I don't see if I'm stumbling and bumbling around the other side. I'll get you the name. I'll even tell you what model it is. Yes, it is. Look at it, all sitting in the weeds. Now that is the old Meek Estate carriage house. Some of the very few remaining trees in their orchard. So we've taken a look at the equipment. We've looked at the carriage house. We've looked at the cottage. Now let's take a walk around the grounds. Now this area right over here is really nice. It's not part of the original grounds. It's something they've done later on. I love that wisteria covered gazebo. And these are aloes. They're actually agaves. Sad to see them look like that. My favorite plant, the aeoniums. They're a pretty plant. It's nice to see them in bloom like that. This is a big piece of cactus. Now, one of these days, I'm going to talk to them to let me get a couple real small cuttings off of it. I have one growing over in Hayward. That's probably 15 years ago I got a cutting. Not that I'm supposed to admit that. Now this is the backside
of the Meek estate, well, the Meek mansion. That's your root cellar over there at the corner. And that was the entrance into it. And while it'll only flash across it on the sign, the area where the Meek estate was known as Cherry Land because of the amount of cherry trees that he had growing in his orchards. And as, like I said, as legend has it, they crossbred cherries and they came up with a new brand called the Bing Cherry, that they called the Bing Cherry. And they called it the Bing Cherry because they had a Chinese cook that could make an absolutely fantastic cherry pie. So they named the new brand of cherry after him. Yeah. Nice little sign there. Well, I bet it's stuck there, I think. Walk around the side of the house. Nice little snowball tree. You see why they call them snowballs, because they're big white clusters of flowers. Anyhow, this mansion is over 7,000 square feet, spread out on several different floors. Had upstairs maids, had downstairs maids, and it had that wonderful widow's walk. This is the main entrance right here. And it is quite imposing. And the construction on this house was in 1869, when his fortunes were at their highest, and he had over 3,000 acres. Now, we'll walk over this way. Well, eventually we will. And this is the fountain. This is my favorite, probably one of my favorite parts of the estate. You're looking at the old sea serpents that are mounted all the way around the fountain. And it's a game that we have whenever we go over there. We look to see which ones are working and which ones aren't working, because all those serpents are supposed to spray water. You know, there's a lot of really neat things to learn about Mr. Meek. You know, he was a trustee for Mills College. He served on the County Board of Supervisors 4 different terms. He helped manage the local water district. He was instrumental in the San Lorenzo School District. Along with Mr. Lewelling, they helped organize and create the Pioneer Cemetery. Just a nice rose. I don't know what variety it is, but it is pretty. 1880, when he died, Mr. Meek, and his eldest son, Horry, took over the business. And he lived in that house on the side over there. Oh, some bees. He was instrumental in, among other things, the first electric interurban line between Oakland and Hayward, called the Oakland, Sanleandro, and Hayward Railway Company. This is a mulberry tree that's over 100 years old. When it fell on its side like that, they just built the fence around it, and that mulberry tree continues to live, and every year it continues to produce mulberries that are actually pretty tasty. But anyhow, back to Horry. He, in 1895, came in contact with the Hunt brothers and convinced them to build a cannery on Lower A Street. Eventually, it ended up with pickle works. It had a can production facility. It had glass bottle making facilities. And it was big packing sheds, big warehouses, quite impressive. But by 1940, that cannery that they were instrumental in bringing in was the largest cannery in the entire world. Sadly, by 1940, the Meek estate had dwindled down to its last 10 acres and the mansion, and they were sold to Dr. William Ream, who lived there until somewhere around 1963 or 1964, when local development was trying to purchase the property to tear down the mansion and put more housing in. Fortunately, local citizens got into it with the Hayward Area Recreation District, and they purchased the property, and it was preserved as a park. In 1973, it was designated a National Historic Site. Just some little weed daisies in the grass. It's a nice place during the day to take a walk around. Now, it's Cannery Park. They're also instrumental in, in that. You know, with working with the canneries. Here's a couple of old Hunts Brothers signs. Now, I still remember way down on Winton seeing a few of the old Hunts Cannery two-axle Peterbilt sitting down there for years after the cannery was closed. Now, the Sanleandro Pioneer Cemetery, this is where Mr. William Meek is interred. This is their family plot right here. If you ever get the chance to go in there on a tour, you'd be amazed at how many of the local citizens you can find there that were instrumental in creating the Bay Area.